Hello, Peltola.
Hello.
What is happening today?
Today?
Yes, today. In this episode.
Ah, okay.
Today we will Dyno our daily driver with the original software and tuned by Lasse software. Let's see if Lasse will keep his job or get fired.
what's going on?
In today's episode we are going to look how much power a stock car can make.
Okay.
And then we are going to upgrade it and do our tune to it.
Okay, how is it being upgraded? What is being upgraded?
We just remap them.
Okay, so it's only a remap?
Yeah. It have had a broken EGR.
Yeah.
And we are going to remove it.
Remove that one too?
Yeah.
So it's the same thing that we sell through the resellers and also if the customer can find someone.
Yeah, we'll have just a tool to remap.
Okay, so it can be sold also by email.
Yeah.
What will the power be?
I hope we can reach 270 horsepower and something a little bit over 600 Newton meters.
Okay.
Hopefully, yes.
So that is what you tell people when they ask how much will they get?
Often, yes.
Okay. So now we will see if it's actually as promised.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We will see.
And what if the remap is successful? Is it possible to get more?
Yeah, of course we can try. We have a good time to do it, so why not? We
can what would you do then?
I think I will add a little bit boost. On base map we have a 1.7 bar boost.
Okay.
So we can
is that safe?
Yeah, it's really safe.
It sounds quite a lot.
Yeah, but always it's on the best torque area. So after 3600 we are taking a boost down because really turbo can't make as much. Inlet air pressure is going really high if try to have two more.
Okay, so you suspect it won't help a lot to add the boost.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's true.
Okay, but we will still try.
Yeah,
we will. And the intercooler will break because the ends are plastic.
Yeah.
Is it ends? Like the the ones on the side?
I don't know.
They are plastic.
Correct.
It's stock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Often it's really good plan to upgrade it to aluminium, full aluminium.
That will be done, but not today.
Yeah, but we will do it on future.
Yeah. In some other episode.
Yeah.
Probably in the next one.
Oh, hopefully, yes.
Yeah. AD Blue, EGR, what about those things?
If you are doing a car which is not made to road car, we can do EGR, flaps, AdBlue, DBF, and stuff like that. Yeah, MAF, of course. So we can do removing to that.
All of those can be deleted.
Yeah. Like standalone EQs, but we sell custom EDC 15. It's always removed all. No
all
need
of those.
Yeah. When the engine is used on boat, on race car or something.
Okay.
Like that.
But it's not for road use.
Yeah, it's not.
It's very illegal.
Yeah.
Okay. Is this enough like preparation? We don't need more. We just go to the Dyno.
Yeah, I hope we can have a lot of questions. It's a lot easier to answer than
make up.
Yeah. Hopefully much questions in the comments.
And would you like, you now have the possibility to apologize for your English.
Yeah.
Would you like to?
Hopefully someday I'm better on my English.
We will learn.
Yeah, hopefully so. Yes.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hey Lasse, where are we and what's the first operation?
We are first time in Dyno session.
Okay.
With this awesome car.
Yeah. And the plan is first to test it with stock map.
Yeah, and then we are going to over map what we sell.
Okay.
Worldwide.
Okay. And check how much the difference is.
Yeah, we'll see.
We'll see. So the check engine light came on. What are you gonna do about it?
I want to know what it is. Is it?
Okay.
And so solve the problem, basically.
So you're just gonna read the fault codes?
Yeah.
Do you have any suspicion of what it could be?
I think it could be MAF.
MAF sensor.
It has been deleted and I put it back on. So okay. We'll see.
And what's the solution if it is?
We will remove it from software.
Okay. So you can do that too?
Yeah, of course. Of course.
Okay. It's that easy. So there was some problem.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay. What was it?
This air was broken, so we need to really remove them from software. So we can take the connector off.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now it's fixed in the stock software.
Yeah, we tried to really go to stock one.
Okay. Yeah, but on this car we couldn't because the EGR is removed.
Yeah.
So that's fixed and now we will do a full as a stock.
Yeah.
Perfect. Good enough.
Yeah, I think it was pretty nice.
Okay, so now we're gonna change the map and do it again.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just checked the stock power should be.
Yeah.
It should be 204.
Yeah. Stock Newton meters is 500.
Okay.
So basically that we are just a little bit over. It's really, okay. Really close to stock. So I am surprised about that. Yeah.
So it's exactly as it should be.
Yeah, it is.
Like the car is probably in quite good condition.
Yeah.
Okay, so next up is making, or the software is made already.
Yeah.
But installing it to the car.
Yeah, one thing we'll remember always with the Segast. It's really strong. It's only with Mercedes EDC 15 and 16.
Okay.
So you will remove the cooling fan connector.
Okay.
It will always going on when you are writing new file.
Okay. But so when writing new software, the cooling fan will go to max RPMs.
Yeah. And it take a lot of current.
Okay.
So basically a lot better to remove it.
Okay, and save the battery.
Yeah.
So what's next?
Yeah, I'm taking a connecting to ECU.
Yeah.
And then writing a new file, what we have made yesterday. Okay. Often we make it like a custom software to every car what we do.
So would you say this is normal a normal curve for a 3-liter diesel?
I can say it doesn't have a turbo converter slipping.
Okay.
Because this line is straight. And if it have a thumb here, you can be sure you have a turbo converter slipping there. Because always diesel engine have a straight line like this. If you want to have a more RPMs, this line coming just the same way.
Okay. So
of
if
course,
it's...
Of course, really, if turbo don't have enough fire to make, so then it's coming down.
Okay. But
if boost is same, it is going like this length.
Okay.
When we are adding boost, our line is going up here and then making same.
Okay. Okay, so the remap is done.
Yeah. We have now all our software.
Okay.
We'll see how much horsepower it can have.
So this is a typical software that you could buy from us.
Yeah. You can also sell them to all around the world.
Okay.
If you just have a tool to write it, like Chinese MPPS or KES, you can write it yourself.
Okay. And if you want to get the tools, you can also get them from us.
Yeah. We'll see results.
Yeah. Can I ask you why did you use Kess? Because we are official distributors of Flex.
Yeah, Flex and Magic Motorsport. It's more important on newer cars.
Okay.
They don't like old Mercedes. So they have made only Benz mode. So okay. I will connect wirings to the Eco. And okay. It's under hood. It's a lot easier to use a case what I have and connect it to OBD.
In this situation.
Yeah, yeah.
But if it came to workshop, you could use the bench mode
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Let's see what it does.
Safety first.
Safety first.
Yeah.
Are we satisfied?
Yeah. Torque is close, but I requested, but the horsepower is not as much.
Okay. But it's still good.
Yeah.
What about the smoke?
I was not smoking.
Okay, so that was 64 horsepower more.
Yeah.
With that map. And that was kind of the safe map.
Yeah.
We can what we usually recommend.
Yeah.
Now we're going to push it a little bit.
Yeah, we want to add a little bit and see result then. And you will also see
if it helps or not.
Yeah.
To put what was it? 1.9 bar of boost.
Yeah, it have a 1.7 and when the power is coming up it take also a boost a little bit down so I think the limit how much turbo can really flow is close there.
Okay. So probably this won't help a lot.
Yeah,
won't help. At least we know that it's a lot unsafer.
Yeah.
It's not as safe.
Yeah, but it's not problem with this car because we are going to upgrade turbo, of course. And you will see how we are doing it.
Yeah. What about the intercooler?
We are upgrading them.
But what about the stock one? At 1.9 bar.
It will broke the plastic.
The plastic, the ends.
Yeah, ends.
But 1.9 could be okay for one run.
Yeah, for one, yes.
But you wouldn't keep it there and drive, or?
No, I think not.
Ihan saman näköisiä kaiken oli Kilipurissa. No oli aina tuon näköinen. Tää
on.
Hello, Teemu. We are back.
We are back.
I think Lasse will keep his job.
Yeah.
I think we have some good news. At least Lasse has some good news to tell their home that he will get some bread.
Here is my results. Then we will look a little bit.
Okay.
Okay. Let's see. There's some diagrams and.
Just put it on the car so the rest of the people can see.
You think so?
This way. Yes.
Okay. Let's see. So.
Will you please, Lasse, explain?
There's the curves that shows the horsepower and the torque. Very simple.
One important thing, we have also TCU tune.
TCU?
Yeah.
So transmission.
Transmission control unit
okay.
have also tune. So that's why we don't have a torque converter slip here on down. Because
okay.
it's pretty much closed when you are on full throttle. You can easily see it. There is not a thumb like often.
Okay. So it comes down like in a straight line.
Yeah.
As it should.
Yeah, and also you can see this torque going up is really fast.
Yeah.
It's really some little
and
details.
And if you compare like to the stock, what is it like a 2,000 RPM? It's quite a difference.
Yeah. Spool up is a lot earlier.
Quite impressive numbers. 644 newton meters and 276 horsepower.
And the car is stock.
It's stock, except Lasse's, who works in with Black Smoke still.
Who does this for a living?
So yeah.
Why are there two lines? The second one is.
Yeah, here is a first one is a stock with 204 horsepower.
Oh, sorry, I meant why are there three lines?
Yeah, okay. It's a first is stock, then is a base map what we use, and then we try a little bit more aggressive software.
Okay, so the highest one was with the 1.9 bar boost.
Yeah, yeah.
And as we see, it's not a lot of difference.
Yeah, it makes just small difference.
But it's a lot more unsafe.
Yes. That was how I was saying. Yes, thank you.
Okay, so what will happen next with this build?
We will cut the springs and put...
Lower it?
Yeah, put 20-inch kullidekkel under and paint it matte black.
Okay.
No.
It have AR suspension, so it doesn't need any cutting.
So we just need a knife.
Okay, so we let the air out and yeah. Then it is...
Yeah. Yeah, okay. But I think we need to pop up the hood and make something there. Maybe change the turbo. Maybe we need to call Peter Racing for better exhaust manifold. Better manifold, what is called, pipe.
Yeah, all the tubing.
Yeah.
And I think most importantly, intercooler.
Yeah.
Because it's still with the plastic, what is it called?
It will blow.
Yeah.
But of course, we need to tune this father model Mercedes, 16-inch wheels. Maybe we need to contact 59 North wheels.
And get some wheels.
About the rims, the wheels.
Yeah.
And maybe world famous Latomaalari.
Okay. So it's you who will change. Okay.
We will not change the color. No.
No.
It's good. But there's some small rust, not so bad. It's actually quite good. Somebody has driven totally shit
driver's door.
Yeah. I don't know who.
Okay.
I think I know.
Okay.
But yeah.
But we don't know what will happen, but something will happen in the next episode.
Yeah, hopefully it sounds intercooler and turbo.
Yeah.
And maybe to going to our street injectors.
Yeah.
But we will think when we are going to change cams.
Okay.
Maybe after turbo and intercooler injectors.
Last question. How much was the price for this modification for the regular customer?
It's often close 400 euros.
400, maybe 500.
Maybe, not. It's 400. It's always 400. You are thinking just money.
There's cheap horsepowers. But if you go over that, it will be much, much more expensive.
Yeah.
But we will explain maybe in later episodes.
Okay, about this.
About, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
Bye.